Okay, today I will talk about the visualization of a compact set in Euclidean space in exact real computation sense. And my name is Jiman Huang, and this work is a joint work with the seminar, Seon Park. Okay, this talk consists of two sections. The first one is a visualization of a compact set represented by a characteristic function. And secondly, we have a visualization of or topology. Okay, let's move on to the first section. Okay, as an introduction, let's review why the single-valued characteristic function fails to represent a compact set. Okay. For instance, if we have a compact set C here, then somebody may want to put boundary and then check if requested point X is outside this boundary or not. So, but this strategy fails because if we put on the X here on the boundary, exactly on the boundary, then it is undecidable due to the equality problem. Okay, let's move on to this. Okay. And this is the formal notation of the characteristic function that we have explained. So anyway, this single-valued function fails on the boundary. So we gonna use this multi-valued function. And so we get a point in Rm, and also we have a precision parameter in a natural number, and we print out 0 or 1 as a multifunction value. Okay, there's a formal notation here, and then I want to explain it with a figure. Okay, again, we have a C here. And then we put two boundaries and the distance between each boundary and the compact set is 2 to the minus p. And we want to check if a given point x is outside of this first boundary. And then also in parallel, we want to check if the value x is inside the second boundary. So if x is outside the second, and also if the x is outside the both boundaries, say here, then we get the characteristic function returns to zero. And similarly, if we have x inside the first boundary, then chi returns 1. And lastly, we don't really care about the between them. Okay. Our goal in this section is to draw a compact set C, which is on the plane. Euclidean plane that satisfies two conditions. The first one is if we increase the number of pixels, say we're gonna draw a rectangular image here. If we increase these number of pixels, then we'll get the correct image of compact set. And then the second condition says if you have compact set C like this, and this one square represents one pixel. So for single pixel, if we have some overlap, then that pixel must be also colored. That's our plan goal. Okay, let me explain the algorithm. We have an input of characteristic function that I already explained. And we also have a range inside the graph. So this is x1, x2, y1, y2. And also the width of a image file, this one. And you're gonna print the figure of a characteristic function in black and white. And this is the algorithm. We have a chi, the characteristic function, range and width, and all the height. Okay. But the height, we need to calculate height, but it is very trivial. And we need to decide the precision to put this characteristic function. But I will explain this one in the next slide. And we're gonna check the membership for each pixel Q, and we pick up the center of the each pixel, and then check the membership of the X. And if the center of the member, center of the each pixel is in the C or K, then we can call out that pixel. Okay, I think it's very intuitive. So the thing is the computing P, the proper P must satisfy this condition. So we want to cover the C entirely. If we have a pixel like this one, then we need to fill in this pixel also. For that, we need to calculate some P. Let me explain this. Okay, suppose we have a pixel of size A. So this is one pixel. So actually, I did not check the chat room pipe. Yes, the fail means undecidability. Yes, closed and bound, that's correct. Okay, let's move on. Okay, we have a pixel here, one pixel, and I put some points on the center. And we have a part of a compact set on the corner. And then what you want to do is put the pixel center into this red area. Because red area, if we put this pixel center in the red area, then the characteristic function will return always one. So that's what we want. And remember that each boundary, this boundary is has a distance 2 to the minus p or so, which doesn't matter. So yeah, pixel center must be in the red area. That means this length is less than this length. That's this condition. By cleaning up this inequality, then we may decide P in this way. So given a characteristic function and some additional parameters, we can draw the compact set that represented by the characteristic function. Okay, that was the section one. Well, okay, let's draw this path or homotopy. Okay. Okay. Here's the motivation. We want to somehow represent or manipulate the compact set in a computer in Euclidean space. And for that, we want to know what would be the building block, or we may think of it as a constructor in C++. Hold on. Would it be more efficient to scale mix? Oh, I did not think thought about that. Okay. No, let me think a little. Okay. The complex set, we want to represent complex set in a generalized Euclidean space. So for instance, if you have a in one dimensional, it is very simple, intuitive. It's just a closed interval. And also in the two dimensional, we have some line segment or path or some box or rectangular, whatever. But we also have some weird form of compact set here. So we want to generalize these all compact set, and then we reach this form. Okay. Since this is a compact set, we can confine this from 0 to 1. Okay. By the way, so after represent, as a result of manipulation, we want to just draw some figures, the demonstration. Okay. Now we are given a computable app, this one. And then we're gonna cover this image of app with several balls, finite balls that covers the image of app. And we're gonna make a characteristic function with the balls we have found in the first step. So, and then we can draw this using this characteristic function, and then in the way of I explained in the first section. Okay, in the first step, we're gonna find the balls that covers the image of app. For explanation, I confined it to a second two-dimensional space, but the generalization is not that hard. And we have also precision parameter here. I did implement the ball center as a having some dyadic coordinates, but let's say it has a dyadic coordinate for now. And then also we're gonna use balls of radius this much, 2 to the -p - 2. I will explain this later when we creating a characteristic function. Let me give you some example. We have some app image. We have a unit square, and then this is a app of unit square image. And then since this app is computable, then we have some boundary or rectangle in the rectangle or box or whatever you want. So we have boundary, and then we want to cover this boundary, not just this compact set C. So if we cover the boundary, then we cover the compact set. So first we try to cover entire boundary with one ball of this radius size. Then if we successfully cover this boundary with one ball, then we are done. But if fail, then we use the divide and conquer mechanism. In the left figure, we have divided a large square into four smaller squares, and then we inquiry again repeatedly and recursively with smaller square here. Then we have some smaller boundary here. Then we may have cover this boundary with one four again, and so on. Okay, in this way we can find cover for the image of F with balls. Okay. In the first step, you can find the balls in this way, and then we're gonna make a characteristic function that represents compact set C, say C, using the balls we have found. Okay, let's define the B as a that contains centers of such balls. The red dot in the figure, and then this figure show the figure on the right shows the one ball, just one ball. We have a jit here. The center is jit, and then we have a radius of 2^-p-2, and what you're gonna do is just putting two boundaries here, the distance from the jit and here the boundary is represented here, and also the distance from here to here is this one. Okay, and then what you're gonna do is it's very similar. We want to check the boundary from here. If the given X, say some point when XP, when the X to put the characteristic function here, if the X is over here, or you can check if X is over here. So in parallel, of course, then we can define characteristic function in this way. Firstly, if we have an X here, then it is zero. We can calculate the distance from X and Z here. And if the distance is larger than this boundary boundary for all balls, then the characteristic function print zero. And you also if there is a single ball or single jit here that contains X in the red area, then our characteristic function must print one. And also, again, we do not care about the space between them. So we have calculated, created a characteristic function in this way, but for drawing a figure with this characteristic function, we need to check if this characteristic function satisfies the necessary condition for drawing, that is this one. So if the user if X is satisfied this one, then our we the characteristic functions we have defined must print zero. So that's why we want to show that this one implies this statement. That's the number one statement says. And also similarly, we want to print that, and we want to prove that this one implies this statement. That's the second thing. Okay, let's take a look at one by one. Okay, for your as a reminder, we have I have put a C and the set of balls, centers of such balls at a red dot, and it is a figure of one ball. And we want to prove this one. And let's take a look at this one. And okay. First of all, we choose any sheet in the set of balls, and then also among this one ball inside the ball, we choose a single point that is included in the C compact set as a Y, and then the distance from X and Y must be larger than this one because we have this statement here. And then also we have a distance bound, upper bound between Y and Z because Y is inside the ball of radius, this one. So, and then the reverse triangular inequality says this statement, and then we can directly apply to these two. Then we get the lower bound of the distance x and y, x and z, which implies the which finishes the proof. Okay, and the second. Okay, but by looking at this statement, we can find that there is a Y in the compact set that is close enough to X, and also since Y must be contained, included in some ball, say Z, with this bound, because Y is also included this ball. So we have two statements. And then you try in triangle inequality, directly put each one, then produce this bound, which is the result. Okay, then here's the result. We put some function like this one. It is called the prolate cycloid. Suppose that think somewhere around here. Okay, this is a ground, I think, and then you have a ball here, and then we trace this point, and then imagine somehow this ball and point are correlated. So if this ball, this disc rolls on the ground, then this point follows this way, this path. So that's what it means. And we also have another example here. Oh, sorry. It is simply a sine function of three cycles, but with a field inside is a field. field entirely. Okay. Okay, I think this talk is very short. Okay. We have in the first section we have drawn some characteristics from how to draw with given a characteristic function satisfying two conditions. One of them is as we increase the number of pixels, then we get the exact result. And also, a cover of exact of the complex set C in the exact real sense. And then in the section two, we are given some paths here. And what we're gonna do is find the one finite cover with balls. And then we make a characteristic function. And then we have drawn the figure. Okay, I think it's very short talk. Okay, thank you for listening. And if you have any question, please do that.